First, a quick science lesson. Most vaccines put a weakened or dead virus into your body, which triggers an immune response. But mRNA is different. There is no virus in the vaccine. Instead, it works kind of like an instruction manual, which teaches your body to build a certain protein found on the virus. In the case of COVID-19, it's this spike protein. That prompts your body to build antibodies without ever actually being infected. So now that mRNA is being used in COVID-19 vaccines, what does that mean for other diseases?
The mRNA vaccines are a major leap forward in the study of vaccines.
Dr. Tim Schacker is the Vice Dean for Research at the U of M Medical School.
This is a new technology that will make it more direct, more straightforward to design vaccines for other infectious diseases.
Here's how. Remember the spike protein the COVID vaccines build? It's the part of the virus your immune system reacts to. Schacker says scientists can find the equivalent of that in other viruses and basically just insert the code into the mRNA construct. Schacker says he already knows of groups using this method to work on a vaccine for HIV.
So I think that's probably where a lot of the focus will go. Influenza is another target that people are working on.
Schacker says mRNA vaccines also seem to trigger a better immune response, which likely makes them more effective, and they're easier to make.
So this can all be done in the laboratory.
Are we going to start seeing more vaccines come online more quickly?
I think so. I think that's likely, yes.
Okay, so Dr. Schacker told Jen then that and made it clear that while the future mRNA vaccines might be produced more quickly, they will still face a standard process for FDA approval, which would not be expedited. Now, the COVID vaccines were given emergency use authorization because we are in a pandemic.
Let's check in with our center.